The love of God compels us to go an extra mile to preach the gospel. His grace and strength keeps us through some of the roughest and most dangerous conditions one could ever experience, like this year when we traveled 11 days up the Congo River to the city of Imphondo, where 2/3 of the city came to hear and responded to the gospel. We loaded the boat in Brazzaville and headed 900 kilometers up the river to Imphondo, well known for a large population of pygmy people. 6 huge barges, all tied together, became a floating shopping center as they filled up with hundreds of traders coming in dugout canoes, selling anything from basic food or clothing to crocodiles or even roasted monkey. Over the last 10 years, Revival Fire Ministries has made every effort possible to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ in some of the remotest regions of Africa, spanning across the continent from east to west. For the Lord gave us this command when He said, "I've made you a light to the Gentiles to bring salvation to the furthest corners of the earth." We have used our heavy-duty 6-wheel drive truck, reaching out to the remotest villages and cities, traveling through war zones, across rivers, in rain, in sunshine, for up to 10 days just to reach our destination. Where the truck could not reach, we chartered a Russian Antonov cargo plane, loading all of our equipment and land cruiser, airlifting it into Kisangani in the Democratic Republic of Congo, formerly known as Zaire. During this time, Kisangani was totally cut off by road due to the long-running war in eastern Congo. This year, for the first time, we went by train just 300 kilometers from Brazzaville to Dilisi in the Republic of Congo. The journey took us along 16 hours as the train wound its way to Dilisi. God protected our team and equipment from armed rebels and from the very real threat of derailment. We arrived in the city of Dilisi, unharmed and with nothing missing. On arrival, we made our own harbor by hiring a front loader, and without a crane, we managed to manhandle the equipment and vehicle off the barge. The fruit of this crusade was outstanding. Weeks after we had returned to Brazzaville, pastors called us, sharing how their churches had tripled in size. Heaven is richer and hell is poorer. No trouble is too much when it comes to the preaching of the gospel. Africa is being saved.